Magdalena, thank you very much for joining me for this conversation. And we just launched the Sony Women in Technology Award with Nature, and we had a lot of discussions and preparation together. What do you take on this award? What do you expect on this?
Well, first of all, thank you. It's great to have this collaboration with you and with Sony. I am really looking forward to the award. I'm really excited about the prospect. And you know, there are a number of levels at which the award excites me. So first of all, it's an award for women. Women win insufficiently often awards that are open. There are, of course, few women in technology. So by spotlighting women in technology, their role, their contribution, and especially focusing on the early and mid-career stages in life, I think we're onto a winner. I think it's a really, really important opportunity. I'm already looking forward to the applications because based on my past experience of looking at applications where early career researchers, women, apply, share their experience, share their contribution, we're really in for a treat. It's going to be amazing and really humbling, actually, as well.
I think this is the kind of the area that we can provide like a highest impact for the future of society and in a career path of early to mid-career female researchers. And we know there are outstanding female researchers made a significant contribution to technology, like Ada Lovelace, and that's a very historical example. And we noticed that the Ada Goldberg, inventor of a small talk, object-oriented programming, or even a split spectrum communication system, has been invented by Hedrama. And with that, her invention, together with her collaborator, we don't have more of iPhone now.
Absolutely, and you know what's interesting is that when we think of names of important contributors, important inventors, I think we all struggle to name women. Even though, if we dig deep, of course there have been women who've played a fundamental role in those technological discoveries and in engineering and innovation, and yet continuously, their role is underplayed. They receive less exposure than they deserve. And that's indeed what the award is trying to address.
The other aspect of this program is focusing on early to mid-career researchers. Reason is we consider more independency of the research in the early stage of the career. It'll help the future career, or will help nurture the creative ideas. And you can pursue your own idea, whatever crazy it is. That is the really the focus we want to address in this program.
And I think that's really important. There is another important aspect to the award. By recognizing and providing an opportunity to women in technology and innovation, I bet we're going to influence the kind of innovation we're going to see. The researcher, the technologist, the innovator who's in a position of directing their research, their work, is likely to ask certain types of questions depending on their perspective, depending on their background. And you know, the classic examples of seatbelt design, which are designed mainly for male morphology rather than female, that has literally become a textbook example. But there are of course many others. The fact that for a long time, up until now, voice recognition software was better adapted to male voices than to female voices. So by empowering, enabling these opportunities for women, innovators and women technologists, I think we're actually going to influence significantly the type of outcomes that we will see.
And I think a different perspective is critically important, and that strengthens that technology and then that more harmonizations with our daily life.
Exactly, and you know, this sort of lack of top-down design that opens up more possibilities makes me think again about our award. The fact that we have deliberately defined technology very broadly. So we're very open to being surprised with proposals, with suggestions. We're not being too prescriptive. I think it will be fun because it will be a wonderful surprise for us. Yeah. What kinds of proposals are going to be
that's right.
brought forward?
Yeah. Sony's name may be faded, but it doesn't really matter. Like, we decide to start doing this because we want to trigger something. And if we get the globe to be the something substantial, more systematic effort with the multiple stakeholders.
And of course, for us, it will be important to follow up on what these women achieve, how they develop, so we can continue to support them, spotlight them, showcase their efforts, but also identify where they continue to face problems.
Yeah, exactly. And I think if we can help them to create a network of the like-minded people and then being helping each other, being influential, I think that helped a lot. You know, I was very fortunate to build a strong network when I was in Carnegie Mellon as well as in Caltech. So the opportunity is like your own effort is one thing, but like helping each other or a network of people with the like-minded people who's agreed and they work together to do groundbreaking thing. I think that's really important.
Absolutely. Yeah. I often talk about the research ecosystem. You know, this is going back to my roots as a geneticist. Yeah. Everything, of course, in genetics happens in the context of an environment. And of course, in an ecosystem, you have these different communities that interact and their existence, their success, in an evolutionary sense, in a lifetime sense, is defined by interactions.
Sure.
Nothing unfolds in a vacuum, and our own success, our own progress and research depends on others' support, and those networks, absolutely crucial. We have quite some ambitious plans, which is really terrific.
Yeah.